We give up.
Hey guys, it's Shelby with Farmhouse Living and welcome back to our channel. So if you have followed us for any amount of time, you have seen my living room many different ways. So we had the before and we had dated paneling on the walls that was warped and just needed to come down. We had a pony wall in the entryway, just some really low quality vinyl planking floor, and then a dated really crazy, I don't even know what to call it, built-in on the back wall that didn't have a lot of function. It was just long with lots of shelves. And so it just needed an overall update. So we tore that out, added some board and batten, gave it a fresh coat of paint, added new floors to the whole house. And by that point, we were completely out of our budget. So when it came to furnishing and adding decor, I just Facebook Marketplace, thrift store, estate sales, and I just put it all together, you know, on a really low budget. I even made this piece that I got off Facebook Marketplace, cut the back off of it, and made it kind of look, I wanted a Restoration Hardware style media console. And so everything was just super budget and I loved it. I really had no complaints, but I knew it wasn't my like end goal. So it continued to develop and I found a fireplace mantle. It is a faux fireplace. I made it look real with this little brick, you know, making it go into the wall a little bit. And I love that. I love decorating it seasonally. I think it looks great. And I would love for it to one day be a real fireplace. It continued to progress with new furniture. I found a sectional at a store that they buy returns and it was insanely affordable. And it's been great for us. And then I also found mom found a chair off Facebook Marketplace, another score, and it's been great. And we treasure hunted the coffee table and the entry piece as well. So a new, you know, another furniture transition with the living room. And it's that time again. I'm gonna make some updates. So I've seen this online many times and I love it. I actually do have a frame TV in the playroom. It's great. I mean, I've heard that the little one is different than the big one because something with the cord, but overall my experience has been great with it. But I want that look on the big one and I didn't have the budget for the big one. And so we are going to DIY it and I can't wait for you to see how it looks.
So here are my supplies for this project. I had almost everything on hand. The first thing I'm gonna do is measure the TV. I did this with the TV on, and you can see my fluted trim that I'm doing a test of my first measurement. I'm using a manual miter box, and this took forever.
All right, we give up.
So I brought in the big muscles to see if that would help a little bit, and it still took him forever. So we brought out the power tools because we had it. Either way works, but I chose the faster route this time just to get it done. And then we're gonna dry fit it together just to make sure that our cuts are right. And then we'll pull out the wood glue and the clamps. I have a corner clamp here. And put it all together. I'm using my daughter's watercolor brush to do this because that's how every mom should do their DIY projects. And then I'm gonna use plastic wood to fill in the gaps and make it look seamless. And then I'm gonna put kind of a little shelf or bracket for it to kind of hook to the TV. And I saw this method on TikTok and it just made sense. They actually had the exact same TV that I did. So I thought, let's just do what they did. And then I put a little piece to kind of hold it, you know, more secure. And I did this all with wood glue. And then you can see it works, it goes on. And it was a little high, so I did shave that piece down just a hair. And then we're gonna spray paint it with a dark gray, so then we can go over it with rub and buff, because rub and buff makes everything look better. But this time it actually looked blotchy and weird, so I decided to use a spray paint, and I wasn't happy with it. So I decided to move on to the next project.
Okay. Oh, it's daddy.
The only one's daddy.
So we are swapping out the couch. This couch looked great, but I really wanted a new look that felt more like me.
Don't put this away, Dad.
It's so silly.
And I just wanted to thank today's sponsor, who is 25 Home, who makes this amazing new sofa that I'm so excited to review and show to you guys. We've had it for over a week, and I can tell you, spoiler alert, we love it. Over the past week, we have already got the stains, and yes, she did eat that ring pop and another sucker on the sofa. So I can tell you, it has been tested with stains, and we've got them out quickly and easily, and it just works.
Okay, what do you think of my frame TV?
The one you didn't finish?
Yeah, so we're tabling that project, not because it didn't fit together. I'm actually pretty impressed that I got that together. I used my power tools, got it, you know, where it looked like it would fit the TV, but the color, it just like initially when I did the rub and buff, it looked splotchy, and then I bought spray paint and I thought, you know, aged gold. No, it's sparkly. Glitter. It needs to be, what did I, galactic blast is what they should have called. It just wasn't right. And so we're gonna table that, but while I was taking that on, we started making other changes, which I always recommend having some other updates because DIYing can sometimes be a little, you know, defeating. It can feel like, I felt like I got so far just to like,
I wouldn't know what that was like.
Mom doesn't DIY, but it was actually really gratifying to still see changes happening in my living room, even though that particular project was not turning out as I hoped. I was like, I'm gonna have all these projects and everything's gonna work out. No, that one did not, but I will finish and I will show you guys. I'm gonna find the perfect gold, I'm gonna find the perfect finish, and that TV will be framed. But for today, it just looks like this, which I'm happy with. The next change we made was a new sofa, and you're gonna be like, didn't you just get a new sofa in April? I did. I gave birth to my son. I thought, I need a more family-friendly fabric. And so I swapped out the sofa, and it just never felt like me. Like,
it was a little bit too modern. Everyone loved it, and we had lots of compliments. Lots of people were asking. But you are, and I am, a slip-covered sofa.
Yeah. Girl. We're not a slip-covered sofa.
We're slip-covered sofa girls.
Yes.
We are.
I love the look. I love how cozy it looks. I love how versatile it is. You could put it in a coastal style, cottage, modern. I mean, it goes in every style. So I like to change things a lot, clearly. Clearly, I like to change things a lot. So I wanted something that I could build on. And I feel like this is just that. My first sofa that I Facebook Marketplaced in this home was slip covered, but the fabric just was not family friendly. It absorbed everything. I have taken this sofa on a test run, wine, coffee, all the food, every snack in the book with my kids.
Muddy paws.
Muddy paws. It has rained literally every day last week and they trampled it. It comes off so easy. So I was very happy. I wanted to spend at least a week testing stains. I know like it's quality, but I wanted the stain proof thing was the most important to me and it passed the test. So this sofa is called the Hygge Sofa. And
yes.
It is from 25 Home or 25 Furniture. And Hygge means intentionally cozy. It's kind of a Scandinavian term, or it is a Scandinavian term. And I feel like that's what we're going for. Intentionally
cozy. Well, I could say we made it.
We did it.
We did it.
And I feel like this sofa is intentionally cozy. So it is, the cushions are part foam and then part down. So not only is it like comfy where you like get a little squish, but it's
got supportive. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And so that, yeah. I feel like that's a lot of times that's missing. Like, I want it to be soft. I want to like sink in, but I don't want to get stuck, right. You know?
And we have a sofa upstairs like that.
It's hard to get out of.
It's hard to get out of.
I want to be able to get out, but I also want to get cozy. It is linen, which linen is a great fabric if you get the right linen, this color. It is very easy to clean, but it's also like solid. Like the fabric is not just going to tear. Mm-hmm. And the frame is wood. And I feel like you would think that should be like, why wouldn't the frame be wood? But these days, everything's made of the lowest quality and it is a wood frame. So that is not the most common thing in the world. It comes in three different sizes. They have a 3-seater, a 4-seater, and a 6-seater. And you know, we got dogs, we got kids, we got, and we've fit 6 booties of all different sizes on the 4-seater. So tons of room. Super cozy. So I'm going to leave a link. They're actually having a sale right now. If you're interested in a new sofa, I think I need another one.
I need 2 new ones.
Yeah. So we're just going to be 25 home people. I think we're just going to keep collecting these sofas and putting them everywhere because they're
so comfy and they're so cleanable.
Yeah.
Is that a word?
Well, it can be a word, but it also gets the look. I'm glad I explored all my options. I'm glad that I, you know, gave a more modern look the chance because I went super duper cottage, which I learned was not my thing. And then I went super duper modern. And now I feel like I'm somewhere in the middle and I'm happy.
And it's who you are.
It's who I am.
It's you.
And that's really what I want this video. As you're taking your design journey, ask yourself, is this me or am I just trying to be like Instagram? We didn't only change the sofa, we also swapped out the rug and then decided not to swap out the rug.
It's a journey.
And I might go back to the other rug, like especially.
Well, I think what you talked about is like using that rug for fall because it's just really a warm, rich, earthy tones.
Yeah.
So fall, and this just brightens up the space. This blue, we love this blue.
Yeah.
It's this, just our favorite color.
Well, it was funny. Normally when you get a new rug, you're like, so the rug is going to go on the patio, but I thought.
It's an indoor-outdoor.
Yes. Ruggable makes indoor-outdoor, so I thought it. Before I put it on the patio, I'm going to try it inside because I do love it. And let's just see. And when I put it in here, I kept it for 2 days, 2 full days. I was like, I love warm. I love that. That's definitely a trend, going really, really warm. Mm-hmm. But it felt too much for me. It just almost felt themey. Everything's warm. And so when I brought the blue back in, I felt like it made the new coffee table pop and everything really flowed together. So going back, I would love to know which you like. Do you like the warm rug or the blue rug? And I probably won't switch it, but I would love to know your opinion because you guys do love to tell us your opinions.
And we love to hear your opinion.
Yeah. Yeah.
Even if it's not favorable.
Yeah.
We enjoy that.
Yeah. So. The comment section is open. For discussion.
And I can't wait to hear how many people are unhappy about
my ripped jeans.
Yeah.
That's so controversial.
It's very controversial, especially when mom wears them because, you know, I'm older.
Yeah.
So.
Hey, I would say a lot of fashion bloggers, this is a style, guys. I know.
Yeah.
These look like 90s mom jeans, though. What are y'all? I'm trying it. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. But I love home decor, guys. So I'm just, if you want to give me fashion tips, I'm open to it. I don't know what I'm doing. So the next thing was we changed the coffee table. This was honestly another family thing. My daughter was never really
a climber.
No, and at the old house, I actually had an ottoman.
Yes.
I consciously bought an ottoman, like a leather ottoman, and that was the coffee table. It was great, but I needed something to set my coffee on, so I got a new coffee table when we came here. At that stage, wasn't injuring herself on it, but my son is a climber, and he's
wild. I mean, he's a wild man, and my husband named him Hot Rod, which was a big mistake because I think that he's living up to his name.
Yes.
And so he's always climbing, he's always falling.
Yeah.
And even though it was an oval,
it didn't
work. It was not sturdy enough. This trunk we're going to test it out.
Well, it's, so far it's passed the test. No one has fallen. No one has climbed. No one, they kind of just leave it be. So the other bonus is if I decided, it's actually empty right now, but I could store stuff in it. So I saw this. We actually found this secondhand, and I was just thinking I would use it for storage, maybe in one of the kids' rooms, but I found this, there's a gal in Dallas, her flea style, and I think her name's Brittany, and I saw her living room on Dallas Home, and this is exactly what her coffee table looks like, and I was like, Mom, I found the perfect inspiration, and her living room and her style is much more boho than mine. But that, honestly, you can look at styles that are different and still glean inspiration from
them. So I think just like this sofa, the slip-covered sofa goes with many, many styles. This trunk can also go in many, many styles.
It definitely leans cottage, but I feel like I've paired it with things that have modernized it. The way that we put the art and everything on the fireplace, it just kind of gives it a fresh new look.
All right, now let's talk about the new table.
This is Mom's favorite. So we've actually owned this table for a minute, but we needed to get some handy guys to come in and put it together for us because I didn't know how to do it.
Yeah, so we picked up this table when we were picking up another piece from our friends in Oklahoma. They go to Round Top. They
shop
in Europe for us, and not just for us, but for many, many people. But we love to shop with them. And so Suzanne had this table in her storage, and
it's called a Montessori table, and it's from the 1890 or something.
And it's from France, and it was the perfect size because Shelby has a really large wall here.
Yeah.
The problem was that it came disassembled from the, you know, container in Europe.
Yeah.
And we had to put it together. I don't trust very many people with putting things together where my babies are going to climb on them.
It's heavy. It needed to be put together right.
So we have a friend from church, and he actually has a handyman service called All-in-One Handyman. Yeah. And I trust him. First of all, he's done work for me, and it's superior. He's of quality and excellence. Like, I can't even... we're not paid for this. I just love him. And I do, if you're in the Dallas area, recommend that you use All-in-One Handyman. And so Yaku put it together, and now we have styled it in the most incredible styling of all styles. I mean, I'm so happy with what we did.
You styled it.
I know, but I'm so proud of myself. Because here's the thing, like, I didn't want to spend a lot of money. And so we used what you had, but I also needed to pair it with something that would
scale.
I mean, this table is massive. What's cool about this table too, this Montessori table,
it folds out.
So when Shelby has additional guests for dinner, she can pull it out, fold it into a dining room table, and have everyone over.
Yeah, perfect.
So, I mean, I think you could probably seat 30 at this point now with all the tables and all the...
Y'all want to have a dinner party?
Let's have a dinner party.
I thought what was cool was, so the mirror that I have is vintage, and then I have my friend Tabitha's art, and then we just cut stems from the yard. But that tall mirror looks vintage, but it's from Kirkland.
So it is a clearance item, so you may not be able to get it very long, but I paid like $150 for it.
Yeah.
It, which, if you know anything, mirrors are very pricey. I mean, some of the other mirrors there were $300, $400, $500 and so this is wood, and that's what I wanted. I wanted a wood to match the wood, but I wanted it to be different enough.
Yeah.
To, you know,
have some contrast.
Anyway, vase came from Target. You can still get that.
Yeah.
And then we cut stems from the yard, which is
always free. Yeah. And I want to talk about, so that is the style. Is this absurdly large clipping from the yard, and I have actually rounded up some entry inspiration, and that is in a lot of them. These are like fancy designers,
and I would say I did that before it was cool.
My mom is not humble, guys.
No, I love cuttings from the yard,
you
guys,
and
I think the more, you know,
wild,
crazy and wild and large, and anything can go. I mean, you just go out to the yard and just chop it down, chop a tree down.
Yeah.
Put it in your room. That's what I say.
That's what she says. Anyways, so clearly you can see the journey. I do think this table actually demonstrates a big, like, if you're looking like, what is wrong with my room? I feel like I'm also on a journey. I'm always swapping out things. I don't feel satisfied. I feel like I don't know what I'm doing in terms of design for a room. Scale was an issue in this room. The big long chaise was too heavy, and then I had a small table, and it just kind of felt
off balance.
Yeah. And the second we brought this table in, lost the chaise, swapped out the coffee table, it was like all of a sudden there was
everything came into balance.
Yes.
And I will say, with your art above this faux fireplace, if we wouldn't have had a tall mirror, that wouldn't have balanced either. So putting the tall mirror juxtaposed to the art on the fireplace, it draws your eye up. And I love it.
Yeah,
love
it. In general, I'm typically that person that makes the design board, completes the design, the room is done. But when budget is an issue, but then also when some, like a scale issue, you really kind of got to trial and error and kind of see like, how is this flowing? This room is kind of unique for me. I feel like the vaulted ceilings, and it is not an open space, and all of the living rooms I had before were open to every other room. And so it was different for me, and I needed to just kind of flow with it. But I think we finally found all the ingredients.
This is it. I mean, I bet you are not going to change anything out. Maybe swap a piece of art or something.
I was going to say, don't put that much pressure on me to keep it all the same.
I think that you're probably going to live with this for a really long time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's just you, and it fits the family.
Yeah.
And I love it.
What would you call my style? Like, I know we're farmhouse living, and listen, guys, I emailed a lady today about getting a cow. So Don't say.
Where's your farm? Because we're getting them. We're getting chickens.
Yeah, finally secured the coop so I can invest in chickens again and call the lady by cow. So don't even.
But here's the thing. Even if you live in a neighborhood like I do, for us, and we've said this before, farmhouse style is a throwback to a simpler time. So when we say farmhouse, we could mean European farmhouse, modern farmhouse, coastal farmhouse. And all that word farmhouse says is we like something that is comfortable for family.
Simpler
time. A place where you can, you know, break bread, enjoy each other's company.
Yeah.
Like for us, it's just a matter of hospitality and a matter of coziness. And
And it's a place that operates for your family. Like an original farmhouse, like you were making your food. You were doing everything out of that. And honestly, today, like my family, like, we do everything.
We do all that.
Everything we do.
We garden.
And even schooling and all of that stuff. So I just think it's important just to like the root of it. It's just like that, you know, the sofa, it's called Hygge. Like that's a Scandinavian, like normally you'd be like, that's only reserved for Scandinavian style. But we can embrace so many different things from so many different styles. And really, how is that overlapping to my lifestyle? And making myself enjoy design as a whole instead of being a grumpy gills and like boxing yourself in. Like,
yeah, like where's your farm?
No ripped jeans. Anyways, sorry, rant. But what?
And we do, by the way, we're unoffendable.
Yeah, and yeah, you know totally what? Are. Most of, we have the most amazing subscribers on the planet. I feel so. Like I have the best cheerleaders.
Yeah,
y'all
we
are
love
so,
you guys so
loving.
Much.
Even the people that come and say mean things about my jeans, I'm like,
it's really about my jeans. They don't like when I wear the ripped jeans.
Well, I wore ripped jeans in the trends video, and you didn't, and so.
And you got it.
I got it.
Okay.
It's okay.
Sorry.
Y'all don't go after the. I mean, maybe they're right, but they're not. They didn't say anything about my house, so.
Are you tuning in to see what we wear? Because you're in trouble.
I will recommend some fashion channels right here.
Yes.
Anyways, sorry guys.
Yeah.
I do want to close with, what do you think my style is? Because you know yours is coastal farmhouse. We have narrowed that.
Coastal farmhouse. I truly am coastal farmhouse. I'm even going more coastal than ever before.
We did a home tour with Tracy and her, it's TM. KF Home.
Yeah.
And
she inspired me. And I just went home and started hanging more
seashells
and stuff.
And we're talking about doing a shiplap ceiling in her living room.
And wait till you see my bedroom and my bathroom.
Yeah, it's coming soon. Yes. We're going to do an updated home tour in March for sure.
Yes.
So subscribe for that. But what do
but
you
what
think?
Are you?
What am I?
Oh, goodness. I think you're a European farmhouse, maybe.
I don't
with
think
a
so.
Flair
so,
of.
No, I'm not.
Of
I'm gonna,
cottage? Cottage European farmhouse coastal? No. Just kidding. I have no idea.
I really don't know. Like, I definitely feel like there's a cottage. I think when I look at the mural in the playroom, that's my favorite part of my house, which I always felt like what I had going before was not leaning into that. Like, I felt like the fireplace and the mural were kind of like singing Cottage-y. Together.
Yeah.
And then everything that was going on behind it wasn't. And now I feel like it's all
so maybe
flowing.
It's modern cottage.
Probably modern cottage.
Modern cottage.
You guys let me know and we'll change our channel name.
But do we need, I mean,
I'm
do
just
we
joking.
Need a style?
No, you don't need a style. We actually okay. have a whole video on that. And we're just rambling, so I'm gonna close the video now, and I'm gonna put that video on why you don't need to define your style right here.
I think everything we've had to say is very important.
I've liked talking. I've enjoyed myself.
Well, that's another thing we get, too much talking.
So
do a lot more overlays.
Yeah, tell me what style you think I am, do you like ripped jeans, what your favorite fashion account is, and what is my style?
There you go.
So,
all right.
Have a great day, guys. We love y'all.
We
seriously.
Love you. We do. Bye.
Bye.